This is the morning of day 16, and this is where I had my tent set up last night. Right beside the river. Not sure how far I'll go today. Probably won't be too far, probably 10 miles or so, and probably end up fishing somewhere. Or I'll just go right underneath Mather Pass. Try Mather Pass and the 14er all at once in one day. See what happens though. I'm all packed up and pretty much ready to hit the trail. Well, I'm on the trail and I think I'm headed to Lower Palisade Lake and then attempt Mather Pass and the Mount Split 14er both tomorrow. See what happens though. I've had worse days, but the two guys that I met the other day, Dylan and Chris, in the evening. I was hiking with them after Muir Pass, Muir Hut and everything. We're hanging out together and came down, and I think we're almost at Big Pete Meadow. We made it at least 5 miles off the Muir Pass. So it's probably close to Pete Meadow. Anyway, Dylan got pretty sick last night, yeah. He's actually puking and he's still puking, which is unfortunate. I really hope he starts feeling better. It's him and Chris, they're hiking together, so I'm not sure. I think if Dylan has to get off, Chris might have to too, and that'd be too bad. I mean, they both absolutely love it out here too, and it's just unfortunate that he had to get sick. But hopefully all works out, and hopefully I'll see him at the Lower Palisade Lake today. Dylan actually gave me a pair of gaiters yesterday. They were Chris's old ones, and he just held on to them, and yeah, he gave them to me, which I've wanted a pair since day one in California, or in Colorado even. I was hoping to get a pair before I even got on the trip, but I never did, and even out here, they're definitely in need. I mean, I stop quite a few times a day to take the pebbles out of my shoes, and they're just a pair of outdoor research ones. Real nice. Keep the pebbles out. Really happy that he gave them to me. I'm definitely very grateful for it, so thanks. Thanks, Chris and Dylan. Hooked up Chris with some food. He was eating a lot more than he had planned on. Well, I mean, your body just goes through so much energy out here too, and you know, if you don't have a big fat supply, on your body, then you know, you start getting hungry pretty quick. And even with the, I know I did, I really did. A couple weeks in, and if you're not eating a lot every day, you know, your fat supply starts depleting and you do start getting pretty damn hungry. So, hooked him up with some food and hopefully that'll help him through. Not a single cloud in the sky this morning. Beautiful morning. Well, I'm glad that weather hasn't hit. I mean, yesterday there was tons of clouds and a fair bit that were actually pretty dark. So, today, not a single cloud. So, pretty happy with that. Muir Trail, Ranger Station, Dusty Basin, Bishop Pass, 6 miles. South on the John Muir Trail. Middle Fork, John Muir Trail. On the top of John Muir, or the Muir Pass, where the Muir Hut was 11,955. Where's that? Yeah, we dropped down all the way down to 8,070 feet, right where the Middle Fork sign was. And now we're climbing all the way up to, I think, 10,600 for the lower Palisade Lake. And then Mather Pass in the morning is 12,100, I think. And I'm heading all the way up to Split Mountain, I think it is. Yeah, Split Mountain, which is 4,048 or 53 or something. Right now I'm headed all the way up to Lower Palisade Lake. I think it's about 2,600 foot climb. Or maybe not quite. 2,400 or 500. And I think it's about in the next 7 miles that I'll be there. looked like there used to be, once was a fire here. Oh, it's a friggin' hot day today. Not a single cloud in sight. right up there. The trail is just right here beside me. Zigzags, goes over these boulders. So it's going across that green section there. You go up, make your way all the way up, and then over that, that's where Deer Meadow is, I do believe. Anyway, that's called the Golden Staircase. Or this whole section up to here, all up to there. I'm headed way up there. Stopped and had a nice big lunch. A little bit late lunch, but I definitely needed that energy to keep on going. Going all the way up there. All right, 10,000 feet, I guess. And the whole time you're climbing these Golden Staircase, you look around to see where the trail is going to lead. just, you can't see it, but man, you have no idea how it just gets around all this. It pretty much everything. Like, you look up there, it's like, how are you gonna get further? But you keep following the trail, and it's just such an incredibly made trail. I can't even describe how much work it must have taken to build this. I mean, it truly is magnificent. Part of the trail. I've climbed about 2,000 feet today already. We got another six or seven hundred feet. Going higher and higher and higher. Oh boy. This is the first Palisade Lake, 10,613 feet. Well, I'm on past the lower Palisade Lake, and I'm headed towards the upper Palisade Lake. I hope the trail drops closer down towards the lake with a good campsite. Wouldn't mind trying my luck at some fishing tonight yet. It's only about 4:30 right now, and I'm just gonna go a little further and get closer to Mather Pass so that I can do that nice and early in the morning. The upper Palisade Lake, sitting at 10,679 feet. What a beautiful area. I mean, wow. Just incredible. Well, it's about 5 o'clock and I've seen this really nice campsite right here, right more or less right beside the trail. Oh, look, there's a deer right there. Sure, it's nice to be out here. Birds are singing. Deer's are right there. Anyway, got my tent all set up. I'll probably go down to the lake. Try my luck at fishing. Yeah, it's relatively early. See what I can do, maybe an hour or two of fishing.